Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature contest is for the WCW World Tag Team Championship. It is set for one fall. Introducing first the challengers via their win last week on the Pro, Marcus Bagwell, Scotty Riggs, the American Males.
Well, Marcus Alexander Bagwell is looking pretty good considering what happened to him this past Monday night. I don't think, gentlemen, I have ever seen a wrestler take that kind of a blow, deal with that kind of an injury.
Well, you know what, Larry, and Chris, let me tell you something. I was there in the training room, you know, luckily in this day and era, WCW provides one of the best trainers in the country, and he sore and was stiff, but he took some, you know, it's like going in at halftime. I remember that big knee injury to the Pittsburgh Steelers guy, going in, coming back out after he took some treatment on it and played the second half.
Now let's go back to our ring announcer.
Their opponents, accompanied to the ring by Sister Sherri from 110th Street in Harlem, New York, they are the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Booker T, Stevie Ray, Harlem Heat.
Here comes the bride. Parker should hide.
I'll tell you what, the wedding is on us. The people in Bucksnuff, Tennessee are excited. Man, oh, get off there, sucker.
That's yeah. Booker T.
And how many times?
Yeah. Hello.
That's Stevie Ray.
Ham and eggers take on the Heat and not get cooked.
They are not ham and eggers. They are former world tag. Oh, hold on.
Better go back to 99 Land. That's the only way they're going to win the title.
They all wanted a shot to talk. They, you know, Pro is so popular, they know they all had to get some talk time in there. And they are the baddest, I guarantee you that, man, the World Tag Team Champion.
Her final weekend as a single woman, Sister Sherri and Colonel Parker, to tie the knot this Tuesday night, live here on TBS, 8:05 p.m. Eastern from Caesars Palace in Las Vegas. The main event, of course, Hulk Hogan and Macho Man Randy Savage, if they can stick together, take on Ric Flair and the Giant, then Sting and Lex Luger against the Blue Bloods. All that and... what a power-packed Clash of the Champions it is, preceded, of course, by this Monday's WCW Monday Nitro.
Monday Nitro, the Macho Man Randy Savage earned that shot. As they say, whether he earned it or not, Hogan say he didn't. But Ric Flair, Macho Man World title, Hogan does get a shot at Dungeon and Doom, member. Man, every time I start talking, this guy get in my face. You know, listen to this. Back to what I was saying.
What?
I'm going to have to go down there, and I don't want to do that. Anyway, Hogan and the one-man gang going to cue it up, my friend, right there on WCW Monday Nitro.
And before we get to Nitro, and before we get to the Clash, of course, we've got WCW Saturday Night coming up tonight.
But this right
and
here,
the
we've
main
got
event tomorrow
big main
night.
Event. Big and, main event, yeah.
And I don't know if Colonel Parker... What's he trying to protect
he's
this woman?
Keeping an eye on Sister Sherri.
Oh, is he afraid she's going to run away?
No, he's afraid she can get hurt out there. There's a lot of beef out there.
Well, that's a very good point. She's a tough woman, but you're right. A whole lot of beef out there, and that is Stevie Ray, 6'8", nearly 300 pounds on the young Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
And he's going to work right on that back. You know, Bagwell is kind of tiptoeing a little ginger, if you will. Because, see that, right to work on that back that was so seriously injured. Speaking of back, he got drop kicked by his own guy.
Right
Scotty
in the back.
Riggs, yeah, nice arm bar there by Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Scotty Riggs came in and probably before he thought about it, drop kicked his partner's back.
Yeah, that was a nice block there, though, by Stevie Ray. Bagwell went for the tag, went for a kind of nonchalant. Stevie Ray just stopped him in his tracks, drug him over, made the tag to Booker T. That's what makes the Harlem Heat so good. They got great ring positioning, great ability to tag each other, and for two big guys, I mean, just physical marvels in there.
Indeed, a physical marvel in Booker T. Some say perhaps one of the best pure athletes in all of professional wrestling.
As compared to what, an impure?
Now the push-off there. Well, you know what I was talking about, I think. Oh, nicely frogged by Bagwell. Hitlock takeover. And look out, Bagwell is getting set.
Hey, I'll give you some insight, too, on the game plan. Bagwell told me before we come on this morning, he said, I want to start because I'm warmed up, I'm hot. If I get cold, if I stand out there too long, that back stiffens up on me from that injury from Nitro, this past Nitro, at the hands of Public Enemy. And I guarantee you, Public Enemy at the Clash, they're going to see the clubbing men themselves, the Nasty Boys. There's going to be some clubbing going on.
Two tables, one on top of the other. Bagwell laid out on top and then slammed through by the Public Enemy. It's amazing. Bagwell is wrestling less than a week later. And look at Booker T lifts the knee into young Scotty Riggs' abdomen. Man, he's not stopping.
Yeah, you were talking about pure athletes. That's, no, they are impure, but they're just different. I mean, there's different kind of athletes. Some guys that are good on their feet, standing there like brick walls, and some guys that can fly around with ease like Booker T. But the bottom line is, who can play the best game of human chess?
Oh, and Booker T almost checkmated there by Scotty Riggs from the American Males, who moves in quickly, pulls him back, and right into his partner's corner. Nice teamwork.
Well, back to the game plan they had planned. He said, I don't want to stay out too long. Bagwell said, yeah, I want to stay warm. And but they need to do that anyway, Larry. They need to tag in and out with these guys. They don't want to be wore down. If they get wore down, Harlem Heat will take you to school and take you home, brother.
They got to keep moving. They got to keep moving. And that's easier said than done, especially with two guys bigger than you that can move just as good as you can. And take that. Boy, Colonel Parker better be nice to her.
I think maybe that was a signal to Colonel
Parker.
That
wasn't even a slap. That was a right cross.
Yeah. Oh, nice suplex there by Stevie Ray. Rolls over for the 1-2, and that's it.
See there? That back hurting him. She fisted him. You put that fist right there on him. Boom.
Oh, Stevie Ray passed it up. Bagwell rolls him up, gets just a two count. So many two counts in this match here on TBS on the Pro this morning.
Bagwell is not 100%, guys. I'm telling you, I can see it in his action, the way he's moving around.
Also on WCW Saturday Night Tonight, we've talked about it, the special interview with Jim Belushi about Steve Mungo McMichael, an interview between Ric Flair and Randy Macho Man Savage. Split screen, obviously, on the same place, Colonel Parker. This, of course, his last weekend as a single man. Looks like he is looking forward to it as much as Sister Sherri is when they get married at the Clash this Tuesday night. And Dusty, you've got a special announcement about a match coming up on WCW Saturday night, and that announcement is...
I ain't gonna tell you till we come back.
Okay. Some silence there, a big surprise at the conclusion of this match.
Watching this match here while you're filibustering.
We'll take a break, and then we will have a big surprise, a big announcement about tonight on WCW Saturday Night. Bagwell in there now on Booker T. Booker T with a handful of hair. The shovel! And look out after that whip. Oh!
Right, they got him right in the back, too. Harlem Heat utilized a great teamwork right there, and Bagwell got caught in the middle of it. This kid is hurt.
Harlem Heat now defending their World Tag Team titles here against the American Males. A tag team that, in fact, defeated the Harlem Heat for the World Tag Team belt at one time.
Right, boy, the Harlem Heat, talk about being on a roll.
Just a two count there, and they are surely working. What was that?
She said, don't go away.
I don't think he's going anywhere. He believes that he has got a prized possession. He believes that there is no other woman in the world for him except Sister Sherri, the snapmare there on Bagwell.
Look at this fuck down.
You know, and when we take a possible look at a situation that is really brewing, as Hogan said too on this past Nitro, looking at this tag match, speaking of tag team partners and real friends, or they say they're friends, Luger, Nell and Sting, hitting Sting, whatever, mistake or not, brother, just adds more and more fuel to the fire that Macho Man Randy Savage is telling Sting Luger's no good.
Well, I think there's just people trying to disturb emotions here and ruin friendships. I mean, just because Hulk Hogan has no friends doesn't mean he has to be a butt in ski.
I'm a friend of Hulk Hogan.
Oh, of course you are, but hey, I saw Luger. It was an accident. He tried to get
rid
of Jimmy Hart. Whoa, what a shot.
A pop-up, not a kip-up. But how do you even call that? What body control?
He was breakdancing on the apron, and he got up and nailed him. That's what he was doing.
Man, did he ever.
Yes.
You couldn't think of that?
That is what I mean by pure athlete. At 6'6" and about 280 pounds, that makes it all the more extraordinary. He picks up Bagwell and drives him under his lower back. And Harlem Heat has got to be thinking, thank you, Public Enemy.
Well, right there, though, he missed his opportunity. Just kind of nonchalantly covered Bagwell. Should have hooked those shoulders down. Even though these guys are dazed, doesn't mean they don't got enough power to... What's on his lips?
Looks like lipstick.
Well, sure it is, man. I'm telling you, this is the... You know, this is a couple days before he actually said, I do. Big doings going on.
You know, moments ago in the background, we saw Stevie Ray in tough shape. I'm not sure if he, look at him. What has happened? Apparently, he's got problems with the knee.
Yeah.
He's limping.
Yeah.
Looks like he twisted his knee.
Well, this surely changes the complexion of the match because it looks like Booker T is on his own.
The way it would change the complexion is Bagwell could make a tag because Bagwell's not 100% either. So they need to get Riggs in there. They need to face it off and go for it. Uh-oh. What is this?
This is whatever Booker T wants it to be. Oh, beautiful move. Bagwell twists in midair.
Well, Booker T waited too long to execute that move, but he got it right back. I mean, talk about regaining your balance and composure quickly. Booker T, very good. Taking a little time here.
Indeed he is.
Bagwell fell into the ropes.
It was inadvertent, but it was...
Look at how close Bagwell was for the tag. He didn't make the tag. He's not thinking straight. He was right there. All he had to do was reach back and tag Riggs.
A very good point, and now I don't know what this is going to turn out to be. Bagwell with a... Oh, man, he almost went right over the top. Now Booker T is on the third rope. Oh, almost a half a drop kick there by Bagwell.
I tell you, but he caught him, though. He caught him low, and he got him there in a situation now to where he needs to make a tag right here. The American Males need to really step it up. Riggs need to come in there and be flying and drop kicking and getting it done right now. Bagwell makes this tag.
All right. Booker T has tagged Stevie Ray, but Stevie Ray looks to have blown out his knee. And Scotty Riggs...
Oh, definitely, he's wobbling on one wheel there, the big guy.
Oh, I have never seen him so vulnerable. And Booker T comes in and breaks up what obviously would have been a pin. We would have had new World Tag Team Champions this morning here on the Pro from the Pro Arena on TBS. All four men in the ring.
Even with his knee hurting him, he still managed to stop Riggs
power,
there.
Power, overpower.
Hey, Parker's up!
Oh, Parker is up! I don't know, what was he doing up with the apron? A double drop kick!
They got a new
tag team champions here!
Nothing!
And Sister Sherri has pulled the knee, and Colonel Parker has come in and pulled the hair. The referee sees it.
He was helping Sherri.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Parker was helping his love.
As a result of a disqualification, the American
Unbelievable!
He was helping him. Well, Colonel Parker ended up getting Sister Sherri's team disqualified.
Oh, he is carrying her over the threshold of life.
The Lovebirds, and we'll see their marriage take place.
You see the look on Booker T's face? I still don't think he believes the situation.
He's not going to be a best man at the wedding, that's for sure. It happens at the Clash of the Champions live.
He's the ring boy.
Here on TBS this Tuesday night, Colonel Parker and Sister Sherri tying the knot.
In front of the whole world.
I don't think he's going to play that role, I can assure you. Let's see this again.
I tell you, right there, I think American Males got a lucky break when the big guy twisted his knee. Obviously, when he got the tag, just couldn't come in and do what he was supposed to do. Sister Sherri saw he was hurt, came over and just tried to end this match and walk out with the belt, which they did.
And we're back with a special announcement about WCW Saturday Night in a moment.
American Males.
Morning here on TBS as we kick off four straight days of wrestling action from WCW. Monday night, of course, it's Monday Nitro on TNT from Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. And Tuesday night, right here on TBS, live at 8:05 Eastern, the Clash of the Champions from Caesar's Palace, Larry, in which Sister Sherri and Colonel Parker get married.
Well, you know, as tradition fills the minds of the young and the useless, and they picture marriage as a fun romp through beaches of beautiful huts and jeeps, we find out the reality is quite different. Colonel Parker should be old enough to realize that the only women you take home are the ones that keep their mouths shut. Sister Sherri, good manager. But boy, what a loud wife.
And big news about WCW Saturday night tonight.
Very simple. Lex Luger, Sting, World Tag Team Title against Harlem Heat on WCW Saturday night.
All right, fans, I'm Chris Bruce, the legend of the dream. We'll see you next week on the Pro.